Okay, this is Vance King. Are you just calling to listen or are you calling for a deliverance session?
I'm calling. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Hello?
Deliverance.
Okay, you're fading now. Are you
I'm
driving?
sorry.
Are you driving or is your battery low on your phone?
I'm driving.
I figured
Driving.
you were driving. It's best that now, if you're calling for a deliverance session, it's best that you don't be driving. You need to be,
Okay.
mobilized.
Okay, I'm getting ready
That's
to
the best
stop
thing.
now.
Yeah, because it's really dangerous, to be
Okay.
talking on the phone and trying to pay attention, also paying attention to traffic. There are demons who cause accident, and they take advantage of people who not paying attention to the road, but their mind is on other things, and they end up causing
Yes.
accidents. Now, some people don't believe that there are demons who cause accidents, but there is.
Yes, ma'am. I'm pulling over right now.
Okay.
One moment. I'm stopped right now. But
Okay.
I'm so glad to be able to speak with you. I listen to you and look at you all the time on YouTube. So I bless
Okay.
God to be able to talk with you. My issue is this. My husband and I, we've been separated for a couple of years now. I went on to file for a divorce, and we don't have a really good relationship. So I'm trying to figure out, is there something within me that's causing that we don't have a good relationship, or is it the situation or what? Because I get to the point to where I don't even want to talk to him. Or, have anything to do with him. We do have a child together, and I know I need to communicate with him, but a lot of time, I guess it's the bitter and the anger towards him that have me that way. And I don't want to be that way. I
Okay,
really
that's
don't want to be that way. I don't
okay.
want to carry the bitterness.
Okay, now what's your first name only? Just your first name.
Melissa. Melissa.
Oh, Melissa. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I do to ask this now, Melissa, how did you find out about me initially? How did you find out about me?
On YouTube, actually.
So what you do, you went to YouTube and did a search in relation to the problems that you was having.
Actually, I listened to a lot of ministry on YouTube, and I came across your videos.
Okay, praise God. Now,
Mm-hmm.
how long have you and your husband married?
We've been married actually for 3 years now.
Oh, thank
But
God.
we've
Yeah,
been separate. I'm
newlyweds.
sorry.
Okay, so. I said, you're still
Yes.
newlyweds in my book. Okay, now first of
Yes,
all,
ma'am.
okay, first of all, when you two married, were you Christians, both of you? Have you given your life
No.
to Jesus Christ? Okay. So
I had,
that's.
but he hadn't.
Now, I'm talking about when you first got married, had you given your life
Yeah.
to Jesus Christ? But he did
I had
not.
you. Yeah.
And you knew. He was not submitted to God when you married him.
Yes.
Okay. Now you know that was disobedience. Any time that disobedience, that gives Satan legal right to put his hand into an affair because of disobedience. The Lord said light have no fellowship with darkness. And that's
Right.
where a lot of couples mess up because they spoke anxious about getting married, especially the women. We look at our biological time clock, we say we're getting older and I got to get married, I got to have children before I get a certain age. And so we have a tendency to actually, choose the first man that comes along that we like and they like us instead of trusting in the word of the Lord. Now, probably. Now you ask me the problem. The problem is in both of you. It's not just you. It's not just him. Now, before you came to the Lord, well, after you came to the Lord, Melissa, did you ever go through a deliverance? Not
Have
just
I ever?
prayed for, went through a deliverance where whoever
I
it.
have. I.
Go ahead.
I'm sorry. No, I was just saying I had went through a deliverance service once before. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, at this deliverance service, whoever that person was, did they confront the demon spirit that had called you to rebel against God? Did that person confront those demon spirits in your mind, will, emotion, and body and command them to come out? I'm not just talking about them just laying their hands on you and praying for you. This is a confrontation. Did
no,
they
ma'am.
Do that? Okay.
No, ma'am.
That's the reason why you chose this man, because darkness only is attracted to darkness. Darkness not attracted to light. Okay. Now, I'm going to have to ask you another personal question. The questions are very important in order to get to the root, to let you see the root cause of why and just after 3 years of marriage, your marriage is dissolved. Did you and your husband have intercourse before marriage?
Yes, we have a 10-year-old child.
Okay. See, that's the reason why you did what you did, Melissa, because you've never been delivered. That means those demons, those things that enter you, really enter you through a molestation. Somewhere down back, somewhere when you were young, there was a molestation. Because that's the only way that these demons, special spirit lovers, they call themselves spirit lovers, spirit husband, spirit wife, attaches themselves to a human being is through a childhood molestation.
Yes,
that's when you was assigned in the spirit realm a demon spirit who is claiming, Melissa, to be your husband, who says that you are its woman and it is your man. Now, this is truth. This is what's going on in the spirit realm. So, therefore, in the natural realm, any man that you express an interest in or he expresses an interest in you, this spirit is not going to allow you to live in harmony, peace, and joy, and happiness, because it's like it's a jealous man. And that's what it was that attacked your marriage. Now, the same thing I'm telling you, the same thing happened to him. The same thing happened to him as well.
Yes.
Only difference is this spirit in him is claiming to be his wife. Is woman. So that's the reason why you'll find him going from woman to woman in the natural realm, having sexual contact with woman to woman, because this spirit who claims to be his woman, his wife, does not allow him to love a human woman as the Lord God has commanded. He cannot until he gets delivered. That's why I tell all young people who are interested in marriage to seek deliverance first, then you seek your counseling about marriage. Don't put the cart before the horse. You have to get delivered, then seek counseling, and then after the counseling, because you cannot counsel devils. Devils got to be thrown out. So the Lord wants you to know, Melissa, that actually the problem of that you've been having in your marriage is stemmed from unseen forces that you cannot see with your human eyes. You can only see your husband only see you, but there are these spirits in the spirit realm who you two cannot see, who's really is causing damage to your marriage. And not allow you to love your husband as the Lord has instructed, and for your husband to love you as the Lord has instructed. Okay? But God's going to set you totally free. Since you've been crying out to him, you came to him, you believe him, you trust him, and allowing you to be connected to his servant, he's going to set you free. But he wanted your eyes open so you can see this and know this truth.
Yes.
That spirit has been with you ever since that molestation. You know, but praise God again that you coming for help because that these spirits who call themselves to be spirit lovers, their aim is not just to show up in people's dreams and have sex with them. Their aim is not just to call the person to masturbate, to watch pornography, to lust after somebody, lust after another man or woman. Their aim is actually to take on a human form in this natural realm and sleep with you and be with you as though it is a human. Do you not know, Melissa, that's what these spirits are doing? That's what they are doing. But again, praise God that that you can't retain for him. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I know as I was talking, the Holy Spirit has been ministering to you. He brought some things back to your remembrance, and that's why your heart is touched now. I just want you to share with me what the Holy Spirit had brought back to your remembrance as I was talking.
Well, yes, I was just thinking about, like, sometimes when I'm sleeping, and I have felt myself, you know, at almost at a sexual peak when I'm sleeping, and I
mm-hmm.
I caught myself, and I rebuked myself because you know, in your mind, you know, when you sleep, but you're in that twilight part when you sleep and you're half awake and you realize what's going on, because I felt it, and I rebuked myself, and then you know, I prayed about it, but yes, it happens, and I don't have the dreams as much as I used to. But I never forget, I had a dream about having sex with this thing, but it wasn't a man. It had a man's face, but the body was like distorted. The body was distorted. Yes, and that's been before I had my daughter. But yes, in the molestation between the both of us, definitely.
Mm-hmm. You know, I just thank Jesus for not allow us to remain as is. Listen,
yes,
you are just showing me that you cried out to God. Your heart, in your heart, you cried out to God for help. You knew there was something wrong, but you just didn't know what was exactly wrong. But
yes,
Jesus
is not my first marriage. This is not my first marriage. They always either cheated on me or did something, you know, against me, and you know, marriage. So I knew something that had to be wrong.
Now I see you from Florida. What part of Florida are you from?
I'm beyond Miami, so I'm closer to the Keys.
Oh. Okay, I thought maybe close to Orlando, because I had a distance and God set free, and about the same thing happened to her. I wanted to connect you two so you can fellowship together. I may still, if you don't mind, connect you two. So if you don't mind, go back to my website and go to contact us and submit that request, and put down your contact phone number name, because I want to connect you two, because she'll be very encouraging. For you two can just get together and fellowship, just build each other's faith up in encouragement, and that is me, Florida. You need that to be connected with another sister in Christ, so you can do that. But again, Melissa, God's gonna set you totally free. Now you see how your spirit. I'm telling you, just like a human man who can't take no for an answer. And they say, no, you're my woman. This spirit is worse than that. This spirit, if you had never got delivered, Melissa, you will marry again, and then probably another 1 to 3 years you've been divorced again. Because these spirits, that's why you see so much divorce and remarrying in the church. That's why. Because individuals have not been delivered from demons in their mind, will, emotions, and body, because the church taught us that once we come to Jesus Christ, everything about us is saved. When that's not true, it's our spirit that has been born into the kingdom of God, but we have the same mind, the same will, emotions, and body. And that's what Jesus said, I have dedicated my authority to you to cast demons out. Out of who? Out of his people. out of his own children, out of the mind, the will, the emotion, body. So this is something that Jesus does through his child, through his servant, his anointed, appointed servant. But we must trust God's word in that where we bind and loose on this earth, he will bind and loose in heaven. He does it. So he's just waiting to hear his word. For us to decree his will to be done on earth, he does it. Now, Melissa, God setting you free is easy. He's going to just throw those devils out. I'm going to speak his word by faith to remind him of his will. He does it. Now, the next step is that you must remain free by being and staying in submission to God. Now, you heard me sharing with Shannon how she had to continue to be in submission to God, because the scripture tells in James 4:7 how we resist the devil and then he flees from us. It's when we submit to God in all our ways. You have to submit to God. You have to receive what God is about to do by faith in his word, by faith in his word. So after love sets you free, now, you just may go to sleep tonight, and all of a sudden, you see this thing again. And so you are spirit, and your spirit never sleeps. It's just your body who's resting. So you just remind that devil of your blood covenant in Christ Jesus. You say the blood of Jesus, and the Holy Spirit is going to quicken you to say the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus sets me free. And then that spirit will vanish. And see, that's how we submit to God, okay? You understand? Melissa? Now, when did we get disconnected? Melissa? Hello, hello? If you can hear me, Melissa, I cannot hear you. You may want to call back in. Now, I'm looking at my control panel. She's muted. No, she's unmuted. Guess who says she's muted, but she's not. Since she's on her cell phone, it might be her internet connection or her battery may be low. She hung up and called back in. Oh, okay. Thank you, guest two. How do you know that, guest two? How do you know she hung up and called back in? Melissa?
Yes, I'm here.
I'm trying to figure out, guest two, how do you know she hung up and called back in? Did the Lord tell you that? I'm talking to guest two. They're tuning in from the well. But anyway, let me see. It shows on. Oh, it does. Oh, okay. See, I'm learning. He said, I assume you're a he. I know I call you a he, guest too. But they said it showed on the screen. Okay, I thought it was another call from Florida. So Melissa, what was the last thing you heard me say?
I heard you said everything. I heard you say everything and about going to sleep and rebuking. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, because the demons are sneaky. They are sneaky now because they know. They know one of the evidence or signs of their presence is when you dream having sex in the dream. They know that. But mm-hmm. So they use it to their advantage after they get delivered now. This is after they get delivered, dear heart. You listening? After they get delivered.
Yes.
They will show up just so that you can doubt and not believe that Jesus has set you free, all because you may have saw them in the dream or had sex in the dream, or they try to have sex with you in a dream. They will use that to convince you that Jesus did not set you free, not realizing that they're trying to get you to base what Jesus done for you as your evidence of what he's done is by what you see or what you don't see or what you feel or what you don't feel, instead of your faith in his word that he done it. See, they sneak you like that. So you have to be, this is after your deliverance, you have to be careful, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Also, now your ex-husband, now have you two already filed for divorce?
I have filed, but we're still waiting. We haven't divorced yet.
They're not divorced yet. Okay, now he definitely needs to be delivered. So don't be surprised after your deliverance, he brought a concern about getting back together. Don't be surprised about that. Okay, I know so many women and men about this. Some of them was obedient, some have not. Was not obedient. Be careful about that because that's a trap of the enemy. The enemy will send him back for one reason, and that is to get your emotions off of Jesus and back onto the man. And when you put it back onto the man, you therefore is putting it back on Satan because the man have no desire to submit to God. So what you do is when if you call back and express getting back together, you say under one condition, you get delivered as I was delivered. Because that was a problem in our marriage because we never been delivered. Submit yourself to God. Submit yourself to God. Get delivered. And then I'm going to wait until I see some fruit in your life. And based on the fruit that I see in your life, then we'll get back together.
Okay. And you know what? Out of these 12 years knowing him, it's been that way, back and forth, back and forth. And when I'm getting to a place where I'm stable and I'm following the Lord, he comes right back in. And, you know, that's how we got married because I was born together and he come right back in. I'm you know, following the Lord. I'm doing everything I know that the Lord requires of me to do, and he came right back in. And that's why this time I married him because I was like, I'm not going to live in fornication, and I wasn't going to live
That's right. Amen. Because our number one priority is our obedience to God. Because a man or woman cannot love us unless they first love God. Because the love of God in them will cause them to love us unconditionally. But if they're not submitted to God, then they're not going to be submitted to their husband or to their wife. I remember once a woman calling in reference to her husband who had left the home, and she kept on and on and on and on, and she wanted me to agree with her that her husband come back, and she kept on and on and on. And finally, I heard the Lord said, tell her. And the Lord spoke to me, tell her to change the way she prayed, change her prayer form. Instead of praying that he comes back to her, tell her to pray that he comes back to me.
Amen.
And I told that woman that she couldn't say a word. She couldn't say a word because that's true. Because he left God. But when a man or woman leave their marriage, they really have not left their mate, their spouse. They actually left God. So instead of praying to God that God send them back to you, you pray that God send them back to him. They need to go back to God. And then when they go back to God, do you know what God's going to tell them? Go back to your wife. Go back to your husband. That's what God will tell them. Okay? So what I'm going to do now, Melissa, I'm going to pray for you. And all of you who are listening, you know, listening, I want you to join your faith with my faith for Melissa's total freedom, deliverance in her mind, her will, her emotions, and her body. Be free where devils are not living in those areas. As long as devils are living in those areas, then they will force Melissa to do what they want Melissa to do, which is not what Melissa wants to do, but she can't help herself from doing it because those devils forces their will upon her will because they are in the house. It's like in the natural thief, when a thief is in your house, they force you to do what they want to do. You're not free to choose what you want to do, you have to do what they want you to do. So you agree, you join your faith to my faith, and that we remind Jesus of his word, his will. He died for our freedom. He gave us our free will. It's not his desire that devils be coexisting with the Holy Spirit who's in our spirit. That is not the Lord's desire. So we're going to remind the Lord of that, and by faith, we're going to believe that when God hears his will decreed upon this earth, he's going to do it in the heaven because he's the one who can grant this spiritual divorce in the spirit realm. He's going to grant that spiritual divorce. So I'm going to pray for you, Melissa. Then by faith, I'm going to speak this disconnection. So, Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for this opportunity again that you've given me to minister to your dear daughter, Father. Father, I thank you that Melissa did not give up on you and you did not give up on her. I thank you, Father, you was right there when the devil deceived her and entered her when she was that little girl. But, Father, you kept her by your spirit. You kept the angels around her, knowing that the enemy could not do what it really wanted to do. In spite of her parents' rejection towards you, Father, you have mercy and grace upon this little girl. And, Father, I ask you during that time to even now in Melissa's mind, let her see your love and affection in protecting her, Father, from all unseen harm and danger. It was harm and danger that she could not even see, but you protected her, Father. Father, I ask you to continue to give her a revelation of who you are in her and who she is in you. I thank you, Father, for putting your forgiveness in her heart, for putting your love and mercy and grace in her heart, Father, to show towards everybody that have harmed her, everybody who has hurt her, Father. I thank you for getting rid of all the hurt and the pain, Father, that Satan had caused in her life. Father, I thank you, Father, that you shall receive the glory out of Melissa's situation. I thank you for anointing her, for appointing her to be a powerful witness to women, to men who have been hurt because of marriages, Father, that they have chosen to put together for themselves. I thank you, Father, that you're going to use her as a mighty vessel of honor, a mighty vessel of power. I thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name, for keeping your servant, Father. I thank you, Father, for cleansing her, washing her completely whole, Father, because now it's her time to go forth and shine to the glory of God, Father. For Jesus shall get the glory out of her situation. Jesus shall get the glory out of her life, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. I thank you, Father. Father, you said in your word, Father, whatever we bind and loose on this earth, you will bind and loose in the heaven. Father, you did not bind Melissa to no spirit marriage. In the name of Jesus, you demon spiritual husband, I command you to come out of her. You loose her and let her go. You come out of her mind. You come out of her will. You come out of her emotion. Come out of her body. Holy Ghost, fire, burn. Burn, Holy Spirit. Set that body ablaze from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet. Give her a mighty flushing. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, 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 Holy Spirit. Everything in her, Holy Spirit, that don't move, walk, talk, sound, or act like you, burn by your mighty fire. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn all evil covenant, all evil contract that is known or unknown to her. Burn because the blood of Jesus has given her. The blood of Jesus forgave her of her sin. The blood of Jesus has given her ancestors. The blood of Jesus washes away all guilt. The blood of Jesus set her free. The blood of Jesus makes her white as snow. The blood of Jesus covered her. The blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus bought her, paid for her, ransomed her in full. The blood of Jesus against all ungodly covenant. The blood of Jesus, by faith, I take the sins of the Most High God, and I cut and detaches her from that ungodly covenant of doctrine witchcraft, because the blood of Jesus has forgiven her and her ancestors. The blood of Jesus set her free. I command you, spirit snake, you come out of her belly. Come out of her belly. Holy Ghost, fire, burn. Burn in her belly. Burn in her belly. Burn in her belly. Burn in her womb. Burn in her womb. Burn in her private area. Burn everywhere there is a mark, Holy Spirit. Burn by your mighty fire. Burn everywhere there is an illegal hole. Burn by your mighty fire. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for setting this captive free. I thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name for setting this captive totally free. Father, I thank you, and I ask you to fill her. Fill her to overflow with your spirit. Fill her mind. Fill her will. Fill her emotions. Fill her body with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name, be free. Be free, Melissa. Be free. Be free in Jesus' name. You'll be free in your mind. You'll be free in your will. You'll be free in your emotion. You'll be free in your emotion. Be free in your emotion. Be free in your emotion. Be free in your body to serve the Lord thy God in spirit and truth. Be free. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your loving grace and mercy, Father. We thank you for this loving cleansing, Father. We thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. We thank you, Father. Father, I thank you. And by faith, I speak against every curse and idle word that has been spoken against Melissa and her family. The blood of Jesus destroys every idle word, every idle thought that had come against Melissa and her family. The blood of Jesus dissolves it. The blood of Jesus dissolves it. Every door that the enemy has closed off, Holy Ghost fire, burn, burn, burn the enemy's hand. Burn the enemy's hand into God's affair. Father, I even ask you to send your spirit to Melissa's house, to her dwelling place. Holy Spirit, move, Holy Spirit. Go from room to room. From corner to corner, crack to crack, cross to cross, burn all manner of darkness and evil that is lurking and hiding. Burn over the house, around the house, under the house. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn, burn every evil object that demons are attached to. Burn by your fire. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. There's no area untouched where Melissa lives in Jesus' mighty name, even in her car. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn everything that's in her car that's not of you. Burn by your fire, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for your presence. Let your presence be evidence in Melissa's house. Let your presence be evidence in her car. Let your presence be evidence in her mind, her will, her emotions, her body, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Melissa, baby, you are totally free.
Thank you, Lord.
You are free in Jesus' mighty name. You are free. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. We magnify you. We glorify you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Glory, 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 glory.
Now,
listen, you go. You go and you share. Share what great thing God has done for you. There are many, many men, many women, married and unmarried, who are going through these things and don't know the reason why, and that is because they have never been delivered. After they've given their life to the Lord, they've never been delivered. The demons never been confronted by faith in God's word and commanded to come out of God's house. They are still living in God's house. Jesus said, he do not coexist with demons. That's what he told me once, Melissa. He told me, he said, Terry, I have some of you, but I don't have all of you. And I was shocked. And after he said that, he had the woman of God to lay her hands on me, and something came up and out of me. And I didn't even know it was there, but Jesus did. And it was his grace and mercy that he set me free, because I'm telling you, I did not know. He said, I have some of you, but I don't have all of you. That thing was lurking in my mind, my will, my emotions, in my body. Jesus had my spirit, but he did not have my soul, though that spirit was there, because I, too, had been molested when I was 5 years old. And that's the reason why I do what I do today, because I knew it was just the grace of God that he set me free, because I didn't know. And I didn't go to him to, Lord, free me, because back then in 95, you know, people just didn't talk about these things. You know, I didn't know no anointed, appointed servant. I never heard about it, talk about these things. And that thing was in me. And God, because of his grace and mercy, he set me totally free. You are free in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
So, Melissa, as I was praying for you, what was happening? What was you experiencing as I was praying?
Well, I know I feel the coolness in my belly. And also, I saw a vision of an old man sitting in the chair, and then he got up like he was leaving. So, yeah, like an old man with a cane. Dressed very nice, dressed very nicely, sitting there, and he got up like he was leaving. So I bless God for that.
Amen. Yeah, the devil had to go. And that coolness you felt in your belly, devil spirit snakes, they had to go too. And you know, when the Lord, before the Lord set me free, that's what I also had in my belly was a spirit snake. Now, at that time, I had three children pregnant three times. And so I was sitting down in my chair, and I was meditating on the things of God, and all of a sudden, my belly moved just like it would move when I was pregnant with my first child. She was very active in the womb, and my belly would shift and move, and my stomach shifted and moved. And I said, wait a minute. I said, I'm not pregnant. What is this? And then I heard this voice say, oh, it's me, the Holy Spirit. And I said, oh, okay, like a dummy, because I was dumb. Oh, okay. And see, that the Lord was trying to get my attention, Terry. And then, as a matter of fact, when I say, yeah, okay, it's like the Lord shouts and say, Terry, think, if that was me, you would not need faith. Now, the Lord told me this, but I still didn't dwell on what the Lord had said. I dwelled more on what that first voice said, it's me, the Holy Spirit, than what God said. If it was him, I would not need faith. You know, faith, we have to, faith don't go by what it feels, don't go by what it sees. You see, we know the Holy Spirit is with us by faith, not because our belly is moving. If your belly is moving like that, you ain't pregnant. Spirit snake is in there. And the Lord set me free. So that coolness that you felt, that was spirit snake. Because the Holy Spirit, when he is moving and saturating, you feel more of a heat. But demons, you feel a coolness or coldness. So in other words, when I spoke against those spirit snakes and commanded them to come out, the Holy Spirit stirred them up, and they had to leave. And that spirit man you saw was that spirit husband. But God had he had divorced you in the spirit realm. You are now death to divorce you as well as your ex-husband truly needed was a spiritual divorce. Spirit divorce. Not a physical divorce, but a spiritual divorce. But you got your divorce. He had not been divorced yet, spiritually. You see, but he needs to be divorced spiritually. When he gets divorced spiritually, then he'll be able to keep his wife, his physical wife. Okay, so you are totally, totally set free. We praise and thank the Lord.
Thank you, Lord. All right, thank you, Lord. Glory to
His holy name. Praise His holy name. Now, I want for sure, if anybody was going to call in, so I said, Lord, I pray. I said, You send the ones that you have chosen to come. You send them to the program today. So I just go online, and I'll wait for about 20 minutes. If nobody show up, then I'll just end the program for today. Now, also, you know, let your friends and family know, you know, I hold totally live public sessions on Wednesday and Thursday at 2 p.m. And based on the number of calls, I think I can have it up to 2 hours. So a session may last an hour, sometimes 45 minutes, but no longer than an hour. So I'll be able to have two sessions. So what I'm going to do for you, Melissa, I'll put you back on mute so you can continue to listen if you care. It's up to you. But I do have someone, let's see now. I have looked like someone from South Carolina, but Let me check with them and see if they're just merely listening or if they're interested in a session. Okay? Now, if you need to get back in contact with me, Melissa, the best thing to do is to go to the website and submit that request form, and it comes to me in an email and let me know. And as soon as I'm available, I'll give you a call. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. But definitely I want you to send me your contact information name because I want to hook you up with Tina. Tina, she listens to our program, so she probably listened to this. So, Tina, I'm going to refer Melissa to you where you two women can get together, encourage each other in the Lord. Okay?
Yes.
All right, Melissa. Continue to have a blessed day.
All God right, bless
you. You too.